Hello, my pretties. First off, I want to say happy Easter, happy April Fool's Day, and happy Sunday to those who don't celebrate. I'm one of those people. My kids are just too old to do an Easter egg hunt, and the grandbaby's too young to do an Easter egg hunt, so we just kind of chill. My next thing is, I'm sorry I missed last week's vlog. I just was wiped from the snow, and we had no power, so that kind of threw off everything. So I'm here today. I'm gonna do week 9 and week 10 together so that you didn't miss anything. Alright, so last week, yeah, the week of the 19th, that was week 9, we had a nor'easter come, and I had a snow day on Wednesday, and we lost power that evening, and so I had another snow day on Thursday because I had no power. I didn't get my power back until the evening, so I would say it was a good 24 hours without power. You know, I had the generator going, just powering the essentials, and you know, we got through it. Let's see, my taxes came in, and so I was able to replace the money that I had used for the new heater, and I was able to save more money than I normally do, you know, before the whole, you know, shakeup happened. Let's see. My skin for this week, for last week, it looked pretty good. This week I have a breakout just because it's that time in the month. And the weird crusty thing that was happening under my eyes is gone, and I want to say it's because I finished off this serum that I got from Unique. It's Unique Uplift Eye Serum. This stuff, you know, it's made with essential oils and blah 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 and antioxidants, but it does work. You know, it does reduce the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles as long as you continually use it. Once you stop, it reverts back, but I mainly used it, you know, to bring back the moisture to heal my under eye area. So, and I looked this up, I must have bought it on sale or something, because this stuff retails for $65, and I don't think I would have paid $65 just for an eye serum, you know, a few years ago. I must have bought it on sale. As for this week, week 10, I weighed myself and I lost a half a pound. I want to say it's because I shoveled snow on Thursday and I considered that as my exercise. For this week, on Wednesday and Thursday, I got on the treadmill. Did work out. I was able to put more money away. And let's get into my empties. All right, since this is not really empty, but I will not be using it just because I think this is what really caused the weird crusty thing under my eyes, is the Clinique Pep Start eye cream. I don't know what it is in here that my skin doesn't like, but it doesn't like it, and there's only a little tiny bit left in here, but I don't want to chance it. Okay, I'm out of the serum, so it would take me forever to heal again. Something that I, again, technically did not run out of, but it broke and I can't use it. It is my e.l.f. brow pencil in natural brown. Yeah. Somehow it all came out and went into the lid. And I tried spinning it up and there's nothing's coming out, so. Except for little chunks. I did order something new, but it's not here yet, from Ulta on the 21 Days of Beauty. For now, though, I'm using that brow powder that I got from Ipsy from Nomad. It's not my favorite, but it does the job. From Pinch Me, I received this sample of shampoo and conditioner to review, and it is the Garnier Whole Blends Oat Delicacy. I use Whole Blends all the time. I like it. It smells great. Yeah, there's nothing bad I can say about Whole Blends. And one last item. The Pericombe MD Preempt Series Foaming Cleanser. That, I finally went through it. It took me, I started in mid to late January, and it's now April, and let's just say 2 months. It took me 2 months to get through that 2 fluid ounce bottle, which that's pretty good. So for money wise, that's pretty good deal. So since that finished, I went into my stash and I pulled out my next item, which is the Skin Iceland Solutions for Stressed Skin Cleanser and Moisturizer Duo. We have in here the Glacial Face Wash with White Willow Bark. This foams up really, really nicely. But I would have to say that as of right now, the Pericombe MD would have been, it is my preferred face wash for the morning. This foams up really well. My skin feels really clean, but it doesn't feel soft. And it's becoming a bit dry. So, the moisturizer is the Antidote Cooling Daily Lotion. It's an okay moisturizer, and it does really cool. It has this menthol-y not scent but feeling in it, that once it dries, it still is cooling. So I'm thinking, like, after you work out, if you wash your face, this would be great for, like, cooling you down. That's all I have today. I hope this video turns out, because this is like the third time I've done this. I'm happy I don't feel like such a loser anymore, that I'm actually getting back to everything, saving and exercising and losing weight, and even though working on my skin has never actually stopped. Other than that, I don't, as far as videos coming up, I don't have anything really for this week. The Ulta 21 Days of Beauty is still going on, and there's still one more thing that I was going to get. So other than that, I want you to have a good day. And I will see you next week.